This device is to be used for a patient who has fallen down, who cannot get up without assistance, who cannot weight bear, or who needs to be repositioned in bed. The following procedures can be completed using a ceiling lift: lifting a patient from a bed to a chair or commode, lifting the patient from the floor to a bed or stretcher, repositioning a patient in bed, turning a patient in bed. The ceiling lift is battery-operated and controlled by a hand control unit, which is used to raise and lower the carry bar. The ceiling lift moves along a track that is mounted on the ceiling. There are two types of ceiling lifts. One type is permanently mounted, and the other type is portable, so it can be transferred from one track to another. The ceiling lift has a weight capacity that is marked on a label on the housing. This weight capacity should never be exceeded. Each sling has a weight capacity that is marked on the label on the back of the sling. This weight capacity should never be exceeded. Ensure that the correct size sling is selected. Sling sizes are marked on the label on the back of the sling. Always check the sling for damage before each use to ensure that it is safe. To lower the carry bar, press the down button, keeping your finger on the button until the desired position is reached. To raise the carry bar, press the up button, keeping your finger on the button until the desired position is reached. By removing your finger from the hand control buttons, movement of the carry bar will stop. Ensure that the carry bar is raised to its highest position when the lift is not in use, so that it doesn't pose a safety hazard to anyone in the area. When lifting a patient, it is important to position the carry bar over the center of the patient's body weight, typically at waist level. This allows the patient's weight to be evenly distributed and allows the operator to be able to easily attach all the sling straps to the sling hooks. Position the patient directly under the lift so that the patient is not pulled to one side of the lift, which results in side loading of the lift and possible damage. Ensure that the strap does not become twisted, as it can become caught inside the housing. If it is twisted, turn the swivel bracket attached to the top of the carry bar until the strap is untwisted. When moving the lift, always pull on the carry bar, which should be lowered to shoulder level or below to avoid awkward reaching. Never pull on the power cord to move the lift, as this may damage the cord or unplug it from the lift housing. If the cord does become unplugged, ensure that the cord is plugged in correctly by testing the up and down arrow buttons on the hand control unit. If the functions are reversed, it is an indication that the cord is plugged in backwards. When using a pneumatic system, never crimp the cord when operating the lift, as this may cause air to become trapped in the cord, which may result in continual activation of the unit. The battery should be fully charged prior to all ceiling lift procedures. When the lift is moved away from the charging station, a green light on the control panel on the underside of the housing indicates that the battery is fully charged. If the batteries are low and require charging, the light will turn red and an audible alarm will sound. When the lift is not in use, the lift should be positioned at the charging station located at the end of the track. When the lift is connected to the charger, the indicator light on the control panel on the underside of the lift will change to a red color. The lift should be charged after each transfer to ensure that it is fully charged for the next transfer. If the down arrow on the hand control unit does not function, the backup down button on the hand control unit can be used. If both down arrow buttons fail, the patient may be lowered by pressing and holding the red emergency lowering button located on the control panel on the underside of the lift housing. Some lifts have a mechanical lowering system which is located above the motor. To lower the lift, remove the key from the lift by flipping the emergency door open, or obtain an Allen key, and then insert it into the slot as indicated and turn until the patient is lowered. You may need to raise the bed, chair, as high as possible to minimize the amount of manual lowering required. If the lift will not lower, call the emergency phone number located on the lift. Failure of any of the lowering devices should be reported to your local authorized dealer immediately. The emergency stop function is operated by pressing the power button on the hand control unit or the green button on the control panel on the underside of the lift. In summary, a ceiling lift is to be used for a patient who has fallen down, who cannot get up without assistance, who cannot weight bear, or who needs to be repositioned in bed. Following the user guide will ensure safe use of this equipment.